Do you want to manage and integrate the tasks of a sales process or other business process? Do you want to automate tasks like approving a quote, generating orders and ordering documents, and entering sales order numbers? Oracle Integration Cloud enables you to do all this and much more. Integration Insight, part of the Integration Analytics feature of Integration Cloud, empowers you to define important business milestones and view advanced metrics right in the browser without making any changes to the application. With these advanced metrics, you can understand conversion problems, identify weak spots in the sales pipeline, track significant volume increase or decrease, track sales team performance spikes and dips, identify product trends early, and surface regional sales hotspots. Sign in to Integration Cloud and create a model from the Insight section. On the Models page, enter a name, a description, and a label. Then select a unique icon for the model. Now, define the milestones within the model. Milestones are points in a business process that represent important events. You create several types of milestones, including initial, standard, error, terminal, and terminal error. These milestones are mapped to points in the business process implementation. In this example, the opportunity to order business process starts when a sales rep creates an opportunity in Oracle Sales Cloud. You first create a milestone to represent that event. This particular milestone is classified as initial. Every time this milestone is passed, a new instance or order is initiated in Insight. You add additional milestones to the model that represent interim points of normal execution. These are known as standard milestones. The next milestone you define is passed when a quote is rejected automatically by the process application if the discount is too high. Because it puts the order into an unsuccessful state, you identify it as an error milestone. The order can be resumed after the quote's updated. For that reason, this isn't defined as a terminal milestone. Add another error milestone to represent when a customer rejects a quote. This isn't a terminal milestone either, because the order will be resumed once the quote's been updated. Add another error milestone to represent an order cancellation. Because the order can't be completed after being canceled, you identify this milestone as a terminal error milestone. Finally, add a milestone that marks the successful completion of an order. This is a terminal milestone. When milestones are passed, indicators can be extracted as Insight observes the execution of business processes. Indicators are key pieces of raw data. They allow business users to gain insight into the proper functioning of the business process and also allow comparisons between orders. There are three types of indicators: identifiers, measures, and dimensions. Identifiers guarantee uniqueness among all business processes. You can specify an additional identifier to correlate one business process to another, like correlating an opportunity to an order. Measures identify values that enable quantification of the state of the business process. Dimensions provide a type of grouping and categorization of instances that enables slicing and dicing of aggregate measures. Indicators can be created once the milestones are defined. Start with the unique instance identifier. Next, define a measure associated with a milestone, and then define a dimension associated with a milestone. Finally, add additional dimensions and measures and associate them with the remaining milestones. After you've defined each indicator, save the model and sign out of Insight. In the next video in this series, an integration architect maps each of these milestones to the underlying implementation and activates the model. To learn more, visit us online. And thanks for watching.